Good morning, guys, and welcome back from Maestro Vito Copelli. Let's see just a little test audio and see how it is. Mi sentite? Come va l'audio? Vedi un po' con l'audio, come va? Check. Si gira. Made with love. Ciao Vito, please guys comment here below and let's check the audio, how it is. Let's see. I didn't have any comment, yo.
We hear you.
We hear you. Thank you so much, Elisi, for waiting because you are the first one, and thank you so much for becoming a member of my channel. Welcome guys and happy Sunday to everybody. Buona domenica a tutti. Let's wait 100 people at least, and then we start with this amazing video, amazing recipe that today I'm going to show you something very special and something authentic from Puglia that I never show you in my channel. It's always related to pizza. The name is Popizza. So the original name, like everybody knows in Italy, all Italy, the name, let's say, in Milano, if I say Popizza, they don't know. So we call it pettole pugliesi. Amici, sì, oggi faremo le pettole pugliesi, le famose popizze, come le fanno a Bari, come le faceva mia nonna, come le continuano a fare, e oggi vi dimostrerò come farle dalla A alla Z. So guys, today I'm going to show you how to make it from the scratch, from the dough to the making it. But of course, I have some dough already made. Those, take a look how much air this is, all these dots, this is air. Amici, questo è un impasto già prefermentato, è un polish, però è un po' modificato. Andremo lì, vediamo un po'. Vedono un poco su, eccoci qua. Abbiamo una bella luce frontale. Spero che mi vedano bene, ci sono domande? If you guys have any question, please, yes, comment, because I have my wife here, she's gonna read all the comment. Ciao, you are amazing, thank you so much, guys. Ok, vai, ci sono domande?
Do you live in Italy or USA?
Ok, I live in Los Angeles, but I'm about to go in Italy for a little bit, because here l'economy is getting a little bit. So I'm going in Italy for... next month.
In New York City area, we call it zeppole. Zeppoli. My Italian is not good, but why the different name?
About zeppole?
So zeppole is the sweet one.
Well, zeppole, yes. Zeppole are the very sweet one. It's a little bit different from popizza, from the popizza that we're going to make today. Today, and it's not totally different. They are similar, but they're very sweet. Today, we are going to make it from scratch, salty and sweet. So I'm going to show you to you what we got here. So here we got the recipe. The recipe that I wrote it down on the description is a 400 grams of flour, 00. We got 400 grams of water, but let me tell you about the water. The secret is the water. You need the sparkling water. So 400 milligrams of sparkling water. I'm gonna say also in Italian, e tra poco lo dico anche in italiano, amici. Quindi, let's get back here. We got simple recipe, 400 grams of flour, 00, 400 milligrams of water, 5 grams of fresh yeast. If you have dry yeast, just put 3 grams. 50 milligrams of extra virgin olive oil and 10 grams of honey. That's all the recipe. Bam. Then we make it later on, and then this is the recipe the day after in the morning. How is the, let me see if you can see, this is the day after. So let's see.
No salt?
No, not yet. The salt is going now. So let's start this video. So guys, pay attention. We're going to start the video right now. We have some olive oil, veggie oil here to warm up. So it's about 180. Yeah, so the temperature 180 Celsius in Fahrenheit is 350. So I'm gonna put the oil at a very low temperature. This way, the oil is hot, I keep this to control. If you don't have the, of course, if you don't have that, just dump a little bit of dough inside and see if it cooks. So let's get into the video right away. We got the recipe. I'm gonna say in Italian. Amici, ecco qua la ricetta italiana. Abbiamo qui, in italiano, 400 grammi di farina 00, 400 milligrammi di acqua frizzante. The secret is the sparkling water. Quindi 400 milligrammi di acqua frizzante, 5 grammi di lievito di birra. Se non avete lievito di birra, mettete 3 grammi di lievito secco. 50 grammi di olio extravergine, 10 grammi di miele. Andremo a fare l'impasto tra poco. Prima andiamo a fare, let's go, and we're gonna make this one first. So this is the dough the day after. So I made it last night, I put it in the fridge, and this is how we find the dough. So now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna add 1 spoon of salt. So basically we're gonna add 15 grams of salt. And we can go ahead and let it rest for about 20 minutes. Then we can start to make it. Amici, ecco qua l'impasto. L'ho fatto ieri sera. L'ho lasciato riposare dentro il frigorifero per più o meno 16 ore. Ora andremo a inserire il sale, farlo riposare nuovamente e poi andiamo a fare le zeppoline.
Your recipe
le pettole.
Your recipe say 500 grams flour and water, but you say 400
yeah.
flour and water. Which is it?
Yeah, also. So sorry, guys. Yes, I mean, it's basically is the same amount of flour is the same amount of water. Here, I put 400 and 400, but this one is basically 500 water, 500 flour, 5 grams of the yeast, the oil, and the honey doesn't change on 100 grams of water. So the one that I wrote down on the description is correct. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna show you. Let's put the light a little bit different way. This way you guys can see better. Perfect, yes. Okay, so let's dump the polish, basically the dough that we made last night in a container a little bit bigger. There we go.
There is a question here. Si. I bake my pizza in my commando grill and put temperature up to 900 degrees. Pizza can get burned at the bottom.
Okay,
what I'm
yeah.
doing wrong?
It's simply, you have to put, he's cooking the pizza on the stone?
Commando grill.
Oh, on the grill. It's too much, the flame, you put the stone before, too much time before. That's the problem. So let's get the salt. This is the recipe, guys. This is the dough made last night, and today we're going to add about 15 grams of salt.
Yes, on a stone, he said.
Yeah, so because the stone, it gets too hot, so you put in the stone too early in the oven. That's the problem. Okay, guys, this is the dough, the recipe. See, I just add the salt. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna make it wet my hand, and then I'm gonna go ahead and work the dough by hands only. So take a look what I do. Really, really hard. We're gonna make the dough. Just like that. Amici, quando fate questo impasto, più lo sbattete, meglio è.
Question, if I don't have 00 flour, can I mix other flour?
Yeah, you can use any flour. You can use a whole purpose flour. Okay, guys, this is the dough. The secret here to make it better is we have to make it really, really hard. Just like that. This is a 100% hydration. Guys, questo è un 100% impasto. Facendo questo tipo di movimento, andiamo a inserire l'aria nell'impasto. Take a look. The air. See the air? The more is the air inside, the better. So we're gonna work it for about 5 minutes, just like that. If you guys have any question, please go ahead and let me know.
Hi, Vito. When you use the polish method, do you add extra water when you make the final dough or just add flour?
Add flour only with the polish. Nice. It's hard.
Why does my dough ball make a hard crust on...
Come on.
Why does my dough ball make a hard crust on top?
Because the oven is too low.
No, perché quando fa le palline sopra si crea la crosta.
On the dough, not on when it cooks. Okay, because you have to cover right away with plastic wrap. Probably you keep it too open and gets dry. That's the reason. Okay, guys, I'm almost done. You'll notice when it's a little bit smooth, the dough, it's perfect. Faccio vedere un attimo. Ecco qua, ci siamo quasi. Ok, guardate, there we go. And here we have the dough is very, very liquid. Perfect. So,
can you do with a mixer?
Well, you can, but with your hands it's better. Because some dough in the kitchen everywhere.
I already learned from you how to make the best dough, but my pizza are not really tasty. What type of tomato sauce do you use, or what spices?
It's because the tomato sauce and ingredients, if they're not tasty, it's the ingredient that you use, the problem.
So what kind of tomato sauce do you use?
I use a Sammarzano 100, Sammarzano. Okay, guys, pay attention now because this step is really important. Now we need to add about, at this point, that is nice and liquid. We're gonna go ahead and add Let me clean up my hands one sec. This way is more simple. 50 grammi di farina. Perfect. So now, simply, at this point, we're going to add 50 grams of flour. There you go, and the flour. There we go, 50. So now we add 50 grams of flour. This point. I mean, if you want, you can even add with together with the salt. But I prefer to do it like this. This way, the salt gets mixed up really good. So do you see? Now we just mix it. We just integrate the flour in the dough, and then we are good to go. There we go. So if they want to use the dough machine, yeah, they can use it. Perfect. A couple more times, a couple more minutes. And that's it. Now we got perfect. There we go.
Vito, why do you use honey instead of sugar in your recipe?
I always use honey because the honey is the best, and then also it's the most organic is more natural, natural product for the dough. So that's what I like. I like to use the most natural products for my recipes. So guys, the dough is ready. So now pay attention. We're gonna leave it at here at room temperature for about 30 minutes. Usually 1 hour is the best, but because we don't have enough time, I'm gonna keep it there for about 30 minutes. And then in the meantime, right now, I'm going to show you how to make the dough for this recipe. There we go. We get the container. Perfect. Okay, so pay attention what I do. Let's put the water in. This one, you have to make this one the day before. Amici, quando fate questo impasto, lo dovete fare sempre il giorno prima per rendere un impasto molto più leggero e molto più fragrante. Che aggiungiamo l'olio, 50 grams of olive oil. Perfect. And then the yeast. Let's get the yeast. We're gonna melt it in the water. There we go. Melt the yeast in the water, just like that. I repeat, this is 5 grams of fresh yeast. If you have dry yeast, go ahead and add the dry yeast. Okay, done. Now let's put the 10 grams of honey inside. There we go.
Domenico D'Augenti, good evening.
Ciao Domenico, buongiorno. Okay, there we go. We got the water, and now we're gonna go ahead and mix the flour with the dough. Gently, go ahead and add everything. So with the spoon, you're gonna help yourself.
If you don't have a pizza plate, how do you put your pizza into the oven on the stone?
Oh, if he doesn't have the pizza peel. This is something that you need to have. If you don't have it, you have to go with the sheet pan. I'm gonna explain to you just right now. Give me 1 second. Let me finish this. Okay, amici, abbiamo integrato tutto, quindi ora creiamo un impasto che deve essere un po' liquido. There we go.
Why does my whole wheat flour in India not form good gluten and become elastic? When I stretch the dough, it breaks.
Because it's not, the dough is not made, that's a good question actually, because this is, okay, let me explain to you. If the dough breaks, it's because of two things. Because the flour is old, or maybe the flour is old, or actually it's 3 things, so sorry. The flour is old, which is very hard. Second thing is because you're using the probably that yeast that is already acid. So depends, I don't know what kind of yeast you use. If you're using mother yeast, that means that your mother yeast is acid, so it will break it. Third thing, which is the most common, is because you didn't mix up the dough really, really well. So if that happened, you have to mix it up for 15 minutes, let it rest 10 minutes, and then you go ahead and form the ball again. That makes it the gluten really be a little bit more strong. Hopefully that was clear. Okay, we got the dough done. Let me show you. This is the dough, how it's supposed to be. Now, what we do, we're gonna cover with the lid. Gonna cover really well. There we go. Let me close this. Ok, ecco qua l'impasto. Pronto da andare nel frigo tra un'ora. Ok, lo lasciamo a temperatura ambiente per un'ora e poi lo mettiamo nel frigorifero. Guys, so at this point, we leave it at room temperature for 1 hour. So I'm gonna put it right here. Keep at room temperature for 1 hour, and then I'm gonna go ahead and put it in the fridge for overnight. In the morning, what I did, that's what I did. I just put I add the salt So 15 grams of salt and 50 grams of flour. So now, let me explain you a couple of things to make this pettoline, so pop pizza. You need to have a cup with water and 2 spoons, because this is how we are going to take the dough, and then we're gonna dump it in the oil. So make sure you have this. Amici, per fare queste pop pizza, ci servirà un bicchiere con 2 cucchiai, così non andremo a sporcarci e non andremo a combinare un macello. È proprio la tipica, cioè come lo fanno nella maniera più precisa, è così, diciamo, va. Speriamo che ci siamo capiti. Ok, guys, now is the time of the question. Ask me anything, and then I will reply to you. Domandatemi e io vi rispondo. Vai, spara. Thank you so much for being here, everybody.
What's your favorite flour for wood-fired Neapolitan pizza?
Is Mulino Piantoni the best?
Vito, is that the unlimited fresh yeast made by you? Love
yes.
The video.
Yes, I created this method, I'll show you to you right now. This is how we find the yeast. This has been in the fridge for 1 week. I show you. This is 1 week in the fridge, and this basically was only 20 grams of fresh yeast. And then take a look what I have right now. I have fresh yeast, so I can take everything. This became like a right. This is fresh yeast, the same color. I show you. The light is really bad. They cannot really see it. Let me see if I can turn it off. There we go. Take a look of the color of the...
No.
Yeah, it's dark. Okay. Take a look of the color of this, the one that I made. And now I show you the fresh yeast. And this one is the fresh yeast. Take a look. This one became exactly like the fresh yeast. Same color, same smell. It's unbelievable what I discovered. And then it's coming soon, a video very particular to make the dry yeast the same of the fresh yeast. So I'm making that next week, hopefully. Let me put this away. Oh, there. Okay, now let's get back to the fresh yeast. So when you make it, I'm gonna go ahead and close it again. So at this point, I can create 3 times more again. So I'm gonna go ahead and close it right here. And you use this one the same way how you use the fresh yeast. So if you put 5 grams, you use 5 grams of this, because that's basically 100% fresh yeast.
It's okay to leave the polish in the fridge more than 24 hours and the biga more than 48 hours?
No, you cannot leave it more than that, because what happened is that becomes acid. And when it becomes acid, it's not good anymore. Okay, so now what I do, I close it really, really well, very, very tight, because if we get some air, we're going to go ahead and throw it away. So this is very important that it needs to be really tight with no air, because the air is what it makes it, the dough, makes it grow. That's when the yeast touch the air with the flour, what happens, it starts to eat and then becomes double up the sides. Dough is about to get there. Voila. So I'm gonna put it right away in the fridge. There we go. So bye, spara.
Do you come from a restaurant family or chefs?
No, restaurant family, pizza place. Always pizza place. I'm not sure. I'm gonna put right here the oil. This way you guys can see. Let me check the oil if how hot it is. Okay, now it went down. So I'm gonna warm it up a little bit again. Number four. Yeah. We need the oil. It's very important that the oil needs to be at temperature. It needs to be at 180 Celsius. So in Fahrenheit is about 350, 380. Okay, guys, if you guys have any questions, se avete delle domande, amici, commentate qui accanto e io sono qui che vi rispondo. Nel frattempo abbiamo il nostro impasto che si sta riposando, sta facendo la ninna. E poi andiamo a fare l'impasto.
Hi Vito.
A fare le nostre popizze. Vai.
Hi Vito, I'm writing for Poland. What's the difference between baking pizza in home oven and special wood pizza oven? The difference between wood pizza oven and home oven.
Well,
yeah, the difference is the temperature. The temperature goes really, really hot. And then like in the oven, of course, it gets to 500, 550 maybe, if you have a really good oven. If at the pizza place, it gets around even 800, you know, 900. So the temperature really makes the difference.
And the flavor is different.
Of course, the flavor is different with wood and the gas and the home. But when you're using ingredients that are really good, you don't have any problems. Guys, in the meantime, I wanna share with you something that maybe some of you don't know. Well, I created a new kids channel with my daughter. If you wanna check it out, please go ahead and check it out. Lo puoi scrivere lì sui commenti. Here we're gonna write it down here. The name is Zoe Kids Toys. If you can go ahead and check it out, please, and subscribe. That will be really helpful. It's a really brand new channel where you can see me in a different way.
Che sono le popizze pugliesi?
Ok, le popizze pugliesi sono un impasto molto liquido che molto liquido e fragrante in questo caso come lo sto facendo io, che praticamente sono tipo delle frittelline molto morbide, croccanti. Sì, sono croccanti dal fuori e morbidi dentro. Quindi queste sono le popizze. Yeah. Okay, guys. Yeah, check it out. In the meantime, that we are resting the dough, Zoe Kids Toys, and then they will be fantastic. If you can subscribe. Okay, l'impasto ci siamo quasi. Ora faremo una prova perché ovviamente ci vuole un'ora di attesa. Quindi noi non facciamo un'ora di attesa. Non ce l'abbiamo il tempo. So, lo prenderò e farò così come saranno. Okay, guys. So I'm gonna try and do one. Just to see, because we cannot lose 1 hour of time. What's the difference between la biga and the canto stio? Canotto stio. Canotto sta qui to lo. Excuse me, Rai, please repeat the question because it's not very clear. I want to say a huge thank you for teaching me and thousands of others how to make proper pizza. My pleasure. Thank you guys for being here today. You teaching is full passion. Yes, thank you so much. And coming soon, something very special on next week. Probably if I can make it, I'm gonna make a New York style, but I'm gonna make it with love and passion. Did you guys check out the last video about the pizza that I made with sourdough? This is the sourdough. This is this is Mother East that I made a couple of months ago. And then I use it for my pizza. And they come out an amazing pizza that you don't even know. Let's check out the oil and then let's go ahead. 150. I'm gonna wait a couple of more minutes. This way the oil gets out. I'm gonna go ahead and try to make one and see how it is. Because the dough is almost getting there. I'll show you. This is the dough. So when you're gonna use the, I show you right now here. When you wanna make this popizza, you need a 2 spoon and the water. So you make it wet. This way, the dough doesn't stick. in your hands, so it doesn't stick on your spoon. So you get, you go like this, and you take a little bit. Boom. You make it. You make a like a ball, similar to a ball, and then you dump it in the oil, and then that's your po' pizza. Okay, let's get to some question here. Like, thank you so much, guys. Vito, will you make a video explain how to do Mother East? Yes, of course. I have already the video. I'm posting it. I have so many videos that I'm gonna post during these days. Yeah, the last video was very good. Thank you, my friend. How do you dry? What is it? Oh, how do you dry a shell of a crunchy and dry French bread? How do you dry out pizza shell so it's crunchy as? Oh, well, you have to just lower down the temperature of the oven. That's how you do it. Let's see the oven. We don't want to make it too hot. 160. Oh, you're gonna see how this this dough will come out. This one's supposed to come very soft the inside. They come out. Dammi un po' d'acqua. Dai, vieni. They're gonna come out a little bit very soft the inside. Dammi l'acqua. Gliela diamo. We're gonna make it really. This one comes out very soft the inside and crunchy the outside. The texture of this dough, it's amazing. And then for me, always, you know, I always make something that my grandmother or my parents that I grew up to. I try to remake it here in Los Angeles because that reminds me always of my own town in Italy. That's the reason why I cook all this like this. La pizza. Okay, guys, let's get back. I'm gonna explain this in Italian too. Vola mettere la pianta, ti? Diciamo ciao. Diciamo ciao agli amici. Okay, guys, say hi. Bye bye. Bacino volante. She's eating. Actually, those things that I made, they're pizza flavor. Those are crackers, pizza flavor. Then if you want to see how to make this, just comment below and after the video, I will show you how to make it. These are pizza flavor. Very, very easy to make. She's eating it. So that's basically like crackers. I'll show you. Dammi un poco di crackers, facciamo vedere. Ai nostri amici, ho fatto questi pizza crackers. Ok, vi farò vedere presto come farli sulla... E questi sono tutti very easy to make. I'll show you very soon. Okay, let's go ahead and check the oil. Perfect. It's 190 Celsius. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna show you the first one how to make it. Let's get back. Actually, I'm gonna try because the dough is not perfect ready yet. So I'm gonna bring the oil here to you. This way, you guys can see. Poi, vedete un attimino la domanda. So I'm gonna try to make one, and then I'm gonna bring the oil there. You guys can see.
Vito, why does my pizza crust becomes too hard?
Because the oil is too cold. Because the oven is too cold. Yeah, there we go. They are perfect, nicely done. Come si stanno gonfiando. Vai, vi faccio vedere subito. Perfetto l'olio, la passiamo un pochettino because we don't want the oil to go too hot. So we're gonna lower down a little bit. The po' pizza is almost ready. The dough, it's out in the, guys. I'll show you. We're gonna cook it until they are, forse non sono mai venute così buone. Forse non sono mai venute così buone. There we go, it's ready. See, it takes only a couple of minutes. Couple of minutes, we're gonna turn it a little bit. That's about to be ready. It come out outstanding. Eccola qua. Perfect. Nice and done. Show you right now. Take a look how it is made. Nicely. See, it pump out. And take a look how soft it is. See? Nicey and very fragrant. Make sure that the oil is not too hot. Otherwise, right now, see, it's too hot. So what happened? It didn't cook the inside. And then if you make it too big, it doesn't cook inside. So we have to make sure the oil is not too hot. Wow. Wow. So soft, so fragrant. Amazing. Take a look. I'm gonna show you how to make it really quick because the dough is ready. We need to be fast to do this, so I can bring it right here and show you to you. Okay, let's go ahead. Let's get it. The spoon is ready. Then now we're gonna make some salty and some sweets. Sweet. So guys, pay attention. There we go. Got the oil, nice and hot. Lower down right there. I don't want to burn the kitchen down. This is just to show you. So we're going to get the... Can I get it? And dump it in the oil. Be careful, don't get burned. And then I'm going to put it back there with the wise. So every couple, you're going to go ahead and get wet the spoon. This way we don't get the dough attached to the... Remember, don't make it too big. Very simply to make this. Take a look. Wow. That came out amazing. Guardate qua, Micheline, guardate.
Aspetta un po', così. Does it need mozzarella?
Well, you can, no, this is just, these are typical like this. So make sure you turn it, otherwise you're gonna burn one side. And we cook it, just like that. You guys watching how amazing they are? Please leave a thumbs up. I'm gonna show you what I do after, because after this we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna put some oh, è andato un po' d'acqua a terra qua. Put some water on the floor. There we go. Make sure to turn a couple of times, or you just move it a little bit, always like that. Amazing. Cioè, amici, e questa è una ricetta super facile. Per fare dei cioè queste sono un po' pizze classiche baresi in 5 minuti avete delle cose fantastiche tipiche pugliesi anche se siete del nord.
Powder sugar, can we
yes
put some honey?
You can do it. I'm gonna show you to you how to do it sweet and salty in just a couple of minutes. I'm gonna cook a couple just to show you. Take a look, they are amazing. La luce è troppo. Oh, there we go. Now you can see much better. Yeah. There we go. Perfect. Perfect. I'm going to wait. I'm going to warm it up again because we want the oil really the same temperature. It's very important that the oil needs to be at the temperature, exactly temperature. But I repeat, this is a very easy to remake. So it's a zeppole. No. These are zeppole are very more they are more liquid. These are similar to the zeppole.
In Bari zeppole are the dessert.
That's zeppole is the one in circle.
Zeppole sono simili a questi. Dipende da regione a regione cambia.
Well, in Bari the name in Bari are popizze. Popizze or better known as pettole. Better known as a pettole. So done. So we need to have a little bit of.
What sauce can you dip in with marinara?
Oh, marinara, simple marinara, and then that's the best. So guys, they are ready. We're going to take it out. You can, I don't have the proper tools, but I'm going to take it out one by one. Put right there. So venuta bene, eh? Molto soffici. I'm going to show you how to do it salty because it's very important now that we do the salty one. Because when they are hot, they are the best. So let's get some Parmesan cheese. Get some Parmesan cheese. There we go. Then right away, when they're still hot, we're going to dump it on top of the the popizze. There we go. Get some more Parmesan cheese. Dump the Parmesan cheese right away. Right away. Now let's get 1 second. Let me get the oil again back to the warm up because it got cold a little bit.
Zoe.
Perfect. Max temperature and then and a little. So let's get some. Let me finish those. Perfect. Ho fatto cadere tutta l'acqua, bravo. Okay, now let's get some. Parsley, ce l'abbiamo questa.
Nel cassè.
Some parsley. Let's get a little bit of parsley. Gonna chop it up. Chop some parsley just like that. Not too much. Depends how much you want. I'm just doing the things very fast for you. Se ci sono domande, vai. Prezzemolo, ecco qua. Let's dump some parsley on top of the...
Do something with Sicilian cake.
Sicilian cake. Oh, yeah, yeah, of course, the cream, yeah. Why not? Okay, now we get that. A pinch of salt. Just like that. Pinch of salt.
Me.
And I have my fish. An amazing oregano right there. These are oregano from Sicily. Then we're gonna dump a little bit there. And voila, we have our salty popizze. Guys, take a look and please leave a thumbs up for our zeppoline. Take a look. Take a look how soft they are. See? Nice and soft and fragrant. So now, I'm going to let it cool down a little bit. Take a look. They're very fragrant. Wow. So good. If you have a little bit of sauce, dip it in the sauce, and they're amazing, easy to make. Wow. So good. Now let's make the dessert one. That's the best one. Give me.
Una per me.
Ecco qua. Vieni. Guardate che bella, guardate. Guardate. Molto semplice da fare, molto soffice e fragrante. E piena d'aria. Wow. Amazing. Very, very, very good. It's very important that you put the Parmesan right away. This way it melts a little bit, and then you get that's a little bit of cheese on top. Outstanding. But the best, let me tell you a story in 1 second. It's one guy in Palermo. Sorry, not in Palermo, in Bari. He immigrated to Chicago. Guys, listen to this. Because it's very important. He immigrated to Chicago. Guys, today this guy is a millionaire. I'm not joking. He went there. He started to make those in a hot dog cart. He started to make those. He put it in a paper bag. He put it in a paper bag. He put some sugar and some... power sugar and cinnamon, sorry, some sugar and cinnamon. He banged like this, boom, he was selling that for $5. Guys, you believe this? $5. This is dough, the flour, and water. So you imagine how much money he made, because this cost you is very, very cheap. And you can make only with 400 grams. I made only 400 grams. And then I show you how many you can make in a couple of minutes. So you imagine that. So guys, leave a thumbs up for this recipe. I'm going to tell this also in Italian because it's so funny. And very, I admire this guy. Amici, c'è un ragazzo barese che è andato a Chicago ed è diventato milionario facendo queste pupizze con lo zucchero di canna e cannella. Dentro un sacchetto di carta le vendeva per la strada a $5. Nel giro di 5-6 anni ha fatto milioni di dollari, ragazzi, con le pupizze, acqua e farina. Let's get back to the reality. One second, let's get the... So let's measure. Okay, 190, perfect. Now let's finish it really quick. I want to burn the kitchen down. Perfect. Down there. Let's get our sugar now. Perfect. Okay, now let's get it back to the... So fast. Go ahead and we can make it. Don't get too much, otherwise they're gonna cook. I'm excited to show you the sweet one. And don't worry about if it gets a little bit of water inside there. It's not a big deal. Beh. Ma stai vedendo qua? Dove siamo? A Bari. Ragazzi, siamo a Los Angeles, ragazzi. Take a look how many
what
you can make.
What oil is this?
This is veggie oil. Riempiamo. So imagine how much money this guy made with only one bag of flour. Okay, so he was selling $5, about five of those. You know, no, not five, maybe 10. He was putting 10 inside a little bag. So you imagine, now let's let it rest.
Can we use olive oil or not?
No, well, olive oil you can, but it's not recommended to fry. It's too heavy, the olive oil. Ci sono domande?
Does the oil cool down of the gas?
Well, if I take it down, I'm just doing this just to show you, but yes, it cools down. So it's better to keep it at the flame. Always control the temperature, because to make those, it's very important that the temperature is always the same. Guys, this is very easy to do, and that's what my channel is just to show you the best and easy way to do it. So if you find something very difficult to make, something... si è rubata una... Mia moglie si sta mangiando tutte le mie pupizze. Aspetta, mo le facciamo vedere. Ok, sì, dicevo. Guys, in my channel, if you find some recipe that is really hard to you, send it to me. I'll make it easy for you, because I will show you how to make it easy. That's why my channel is becoming really successful, because the people are really discovering that I'm doing the things very easy for you, because you are in the kitchen. You are not a chef professional, or even if you are a chef professional, you have to know the easy way to do it, to make it easy and make it more fancy. I mean, this is street food from Bari, very easy to do. So I don't want to make it so difficult with the grams, blah, 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 fermentation, 3 hours. But it's a very simple recipe. Let me turn off the oil. So let's get the stuff that we need. So we need sugar. We need sugar. Dov'è la Nutella? Excited with this one. Ma la dai un po' di Nutella? Ah, sta là, perfetto. So for this one, the sweet one, we need some sugar, some Nutella, and some honey. See, this one needs to go back in the oil one second, because it gets, see, if they get too crunchy, it's not good how it's supposed to be. So I'm gonna put it back in the oil. This way they don't cool down. And then we have this. Show you right now how to do it with the sweet way. Guys, please share with this little, you see this little arrow here? Go ahead and share and WhatsApp with a lot of people. Perfect, oh my God. Oh my God, wow. Outstanding, so we need a cup, just like that, because we're gonna put the sugar in. But before, we're gonna put it right here. Very excited to show you. Let's see if we have some powdered sugar. So that's the goal, you know. You have to make things that you have in the house every day. You're gonna make things that you have in the house. So I don't have powdered sugar, I have a sugar regular, I put sugar regular. I have some Nutella, I put some Nutella, you know, things like this, very easy and simple to do. Okay, they are ready. Let me take it out. Yes, perfect. Let me get this one, which is much better. This one. Take it out. One by one. And I'm going to... So, stay so beautiful. They look so, so fun. And then... They are really light, guys. They are very light this way. Because usually, I explain to you one second. Let me take this out. I want to explain to you one thing. Put those. Those are very light and very fragrant to do it because you made the dough the day before. So now they're really hot still. Okay? Let's go ahead and let's dump it right there. Just like that. Once they're really hot, you have to do this one. Always when they are really hot. Let's get a handful of sugar. Let's get the other two. Or the other. Perfect. Done. Let's dump it right there. Again, some sugar. Okay. Now, take a look what I do now. Just a moment. Okay, non ci sono altre domande? Thank you so much, guys, for sharing. We are 300 people. That's amazing. Let's get this one more. Voila. Okay, I keep the oven, the oil lower down a little bit. So now, let's close it really well. If you have a bag of paper, a paper bag, go ahead and do it in the paper bag. If it's not, you're gonna do like this. So now let's make a dance. Dance, 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 dance. Whoa. Almost ready. Almost ready. You're gonna dance with the food. You're gonna have love. Giusto, papà. Okay, they're about to be ready. They are about to be pump. Let's get back. And voila. Out of this world. Out of this world. Yes. Now, let's get a clean paper.
Ciao Vito, si conservano bene in due giorni.
Well, forse sì, forse. No? Non sono sicuro, non ti so rispondere, scusami. Okay, done. So now, let's get everything right here. Let's get one by one. Oh, man. Look how soft. Look at this. How soft they are. Let's get it right here. No, man, lo so che giorno è uno, lo so. Done. Got some sugar. No, sta tapos. Some sugar. Let's clean the hands. And now, l'olio sta basso. Sì, sì, mi serve, dobbiamo finirla. Okay. Now let's get some. Chiudi, papà, chiudi. Let's get some Nutella.
Due.
Some fresh Nutella. Who doesn't like Nutella, guys? Who doesn't like Nutella? Mmm. I love it. Okay, so now let's get a fork. And that's the best part. Mix up some Nutella. And now let's go ahead and let's just dump like this. These are very typical. You guys can sell this in the restaurant easily for $10. Wow. Amici, potete vendere queste qui nel vostro ristorante e vi garantisco una cosa. Quando la gente si assaggia, dà un morso a queste popizze, ragazzi, escono pazzi. Perché voi li fate arrivare, boom, in Italy, dicono, che cosa sta succedendo? Cosa sta succedendo? Una bomba di sapori nella mente, che voi neanche potete immaginare. Ed è questo il goal. Questo è il goal. Lanciare un messaggio alla gente con l'amore del cibo. Guys, we're about to be done. Now, one more step is the honey. What is the honey? There we go, it's right there. Let's put a honey, scoop like this. Just a little bit, not too much. That's it. That's it. That's it. If you have caramel, go with caramel. Be creative. Take a look, guys. I mean, I want to show you with the light because this light is so bad. Let me show you with the light. This way you guys leave a thumbs up if you like it. Take a look. Take a look. I mean, are you watching? Take a look. How soft they look. How beautiful. I love to do those things, guys. I love it. Honey, I never thought about why it's so good. Yeah, now is the time. Wow. They're so good, guys. A little bit hot. I'm about to taste one of those because I assure you. Let me get close to the camera. Take a look. Wow. Soft. How can I explain to you this? I personally don't like sweets, but this is so good. How can I explain to you what we did today? It's magical, guys. It's magical what we did today because this is simple, but if you don't know, you never taste it. So I hope that I'm bringing to you my feeling to you about this this food. So, I mean, I explain to you. See this? This is the best because it's crunchy from the outside and soft the inside. So this is the goal. Take a look how fragrant they are. You get, so when you eat it, you see, you get that crunch from outside and the soft the inside. So basically, I'm not shy to say, basically, you make love with the food. I'm not joking because it's outstanding. It's outstanding. Guys, what can I say? What can I say? Let me read some comments to you. You can hear the crispiness. Yes. It's magical, guys. It's a torture. It's a torture watching. Thank you very much, guys. It's called magic. Yes. Thank you so much, guys. I really, really thank you to you all of you. This was a quick video. Let me lower down this. I hope you like it. I hope you enjoy it really much, like I did making it for you, because it makes me, I don't know, I feel really good when you guys are here and with me watching what I do. So this is really how they do it. No secret, nothing. Actually, secret is the sparkling water. Yeah, they are so easy to do. Please remake it. Tag me on Instagram. If you can, go on my daughter's channel, Zoe Kids Toys, and subscribe there. And just for the support. And thank you so much. Buonissimi. Complimenti. Mi stai facendo morire di fame. Ok, ora non vi resta che farle. Ragazzi, vi ringrazio tantissimo per essere qui con me oggi Buonissima domenica, sono contentissimo che hanno riaperto tutto. Tra poco ci vedremo in Italia. Sarò il giorno 6, parto, sperando che non ci cancellino il volo. Niente, sarò lì, sto costruendo il mio nuovo studio e spero di uno alla volta di invitarvi nel mio studio a casa mia e farvi vedere cosa faccio in persona. Guys, thank you so much. We call it Zalabagna in Egypt. Oh, okay. Good to know. Guys, I'm gonna eat one more, just the salty one. I prefer the salty one. And then I'll let you hear the crunch of these beauties.
Sì.
And soft, the inside, even when they are cold, they are so good. Pettoli a Taranto, già, certo, Aldo, sì. In Puglia vengono chiamate, cioè in Italia in generale, vengono chiamate pettole, però a Bari in particolare le chiamano popizze. Non so perché, però questo qui è un... tu sei di Taranto, sicuramente le conosci perché le fanno anche in tutta la Puglia. Ok, amici, grazie per essere qui con me oggi e buona domenica a tutti. Condividete sempre i video, iscrivetevi, ogni mercoledì e sabato esce un nuovo video. E la domenica sempre live, alle 11 a questo orario. Your wife and kid must be dying to eat. Yeah, they are right there. Igor, la vuoi una? Yeah, they are... La vuoi una? Non è questa lunga? Se la frega, guarda. Ti lo so, ti. Prendila, dai. L'acqua, la vieni da sotto, dai. Prendila, ecco qua, si sta rubando una, ecco qua. Dici com'è, anche se non ti vuoi fare vedere, dici com'è. Lo so, assaggiare papà, vediamo se l'assaggiano, non è assaggiata, ragazzi. She never tastes those, anzi, sweet one.
No, not the sweet one.
Ok, perché c'è la Nutella. Ok, assaggio papà, la pizza. Assaggio. Non mi shy. La pizza assaggia.
Yeah!
Papalline. Yeah. Assaggia. Dopo me, un giochino. Assaggia, papà, fai vedere. Mangia. Andiamo a me. Assaggia, papà. Assaggia un morso. La prima volta, guys. This is the first time. Vincent, thank you so much for your donation, my friend. First time she tasting it. How is it? Com'è? Com'è? Com'è, papà? Buona? Vuoi un'altra? So, se prendi un'altra, vuol dire che è buona. Yeah. Yeah, papà. She's very shy today. I don't know why. Yeah, papà. La pallina, sì. C'è la luce, sì.
C'è l'antenna.
Ecco qua, tira il morso, there we go, she like it. So guys, thumbs up if you like those amazing popizze. Vince Romano, thank you so much, yeah, for your donation, my friend. Thank you for being here to me today. Guys, thank you. Thumbs up, subscribe, and see you at the next one with a new video. Yeah, definitely she like it. Outstanding. For the people that just got here, this is what we made today. We made some sweet and salty for pizza. This is mine. I'll see you Wednesday with a new video. Ciao a tutti, amici. Mwah! Big hugs. Mwah. Ciao a tutti. Let me close this. Amazing.